जब अकबर ओसले एंड आई एम हैप्पी टू वेलकम यू ऑल बैक आफ्टर अ क्वाइट लॉन्ग गैप फॉर अ न्यू वीडियो फ्रॉम माय चैनल. यस, दिस इज अ क्वाइट लॉन्ग गैप बिकॉज ड्यू टू माय रेगुलर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस आई एम अनेबल टू स्पेयर टाइम इन प्रिपेयरिंग दिस वीडियो. बट नाउ आई एम कमिंग विद एन इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक दैट इज अकाउंटिंग फॉर मैनेजमेंट एंड अ फ्यू पीपल रिक्वेस्टेड मी पर्सनली टू गिव वीडियो ऑन अकाउंटिंग. And these set of videos which I'm going to start from now will be helpful for anyone who is into a business but lack knowledge about the accounting concept, and also students who are doing management courses like MBA or any other courses, and they are from other discipline and want to know something basic related to accountancy. This set of videos will be helpful for you. Today we are going to see about introduction to accounting. This is going to be the first video in this channel. More videos are going to come. Hope I give them frequently without much gap as I have done it so far. So as always, you know, watch the video completely, and if you feel happy and satisfied with the video, give your feedbacks. And if you need anything additional also, you can share that in your comments, and if you feel it will be useful for your other friends, do share them with them, and also you can subscribe my channel. Okay, right, without further delay, let us get into the video. Introduction to accounting, right? So before starting into the basic things of accounting, first we should have some, what we should know, what is accounting, where does it started, does the accounting is having a starting point, all that, I know we want to know. And in simple, accounting is the language of business, right? Right now I'm talking to you in English. Anyone who know English can understand what I'm telling. Similarly, if you want to know the financial position of a business, you need to know the language of accounting. Only when you know the language of accounting, you can understand the financial aspect of a business. Business activities involves exchange of money. I hope so everyone will agree with this concept. If you take a business activity, majority of them, it involves exchange of money, right? And all the activities which involves money need to be recorded systematically, scientifically and uniformly. So when this activity is involve money, exchange of money, right, we need to record it, right? Normally we do it in home, right? We do it in our daily life. We have some money, we get a salary, and we say that, okay, I give this much to rent, this much to my grocery expenses. So you record of things, right? So similarly, all activities which involve money need to be recorded, and this cannot be recorded as we do in home in our own style, our own way, and without any particular order. You have to do it systematically, that is, you have to do it in an order. It should be scientific, it should not be a raw data, raw information, it should be an accurate information, and uniformly. Uniformly in the sense means, so the way I record should match with the way it is being done, so it the others follow. So there should be a uniformity in the way of recording. So the recorded information essential for future decision making of business. So why we do this recording? Because whenever we make any decision, we always know that, you know, rational decisions are more powerful than emotional decision. You want to take a rational decision, you need facts to take a decision. That's why we need to record all the things, so that this will be helpful for us in the future decision making. And initially this process of recording is known as bookkeeping. So what is meant by bookkeeping? Bookkeeping is the process of recording financial transaction in the books of accounts. So we have an accounts book, so in that we are recording the financial transaction, as simple as that. It is the primary stage in the accounting process. So in, when you say accounting process, involves recording, it involves classifying, it involves analyzing, it involves interpreting. But the first stage, the first thing you have to do is recording. It is the primary stage in accounting process. It includes recording the transaction and classifying the same under proper head. So bookkeeping means it not only involves recording, also the recorded information is classified under proper heads like expenses, income, this person, that person, right? You're classifying it under proper head. So how does it is being defined? R.N. Carter defines bookkeeping as the science and art of recording correctly in the books of account all those business transaction of money or money's worth. So here it is a science in art of recording what you're going to recording it correctly in the book of account, what you're going to record all the business transaction which involves money or money's worth. Money's worth means sometimes we exchange money, sometimes we exchange something in terms of money. We are selling goods means, okay, here we are getting some 10,000. In turn, we are giving a goods worth 10,000. So exchange of money. So that's what we call it as bookkeeping. So when bookkeeping is done so systematically and accurately, but still bookkeeping have some limitation. What is that limitation? Only monetary transactions are recorded in the books of account. So in the books of account, in the traditional bookkeeping process, they do consider only the monetary transaction. The transaction which have other impact is not being considered. And effect of price level changes are not considered. Price level changes do happen of many reasons, maybe due to competition or to deflation or to inflations, some economic changes, the price level changes, but that is not being considered in the traditional bookkeeping. Financial data recorded are historical in nature, that is only past data are recorded. So when the recorded data, all the financial data are recorded only in the historical basis, that is past data is only taken into consideration. So bookkeeping is very limited. Okay, that's why something a better way than bookkeeping is expected. So that a better way than bookkeeping is what? Accounting. So accounting is, accounting do record past datas. Accounting do have a place where you think about future. It is something better which is not only sticking itself to the past, it is going beyond the past. That's why, you know, accounting is NS level of bookkeeping. What is mean by an accounting? Accounting is the systematic process of identifying, measuring, recording, classifying, summarizing, interpreting and communicating financial information. When we were seeing about bookkeeping, it is all about recording and classifying, but accounting is something beyond recording and classifying, where it starts way much before, that is identifying the business transaction. So in a business, you are identifying the business transaction which involve the financial aspect, and you're measuring it, and after measuring it, you're recording it, and recording is then classified. You classify and record it. Not only you end with classify, then summarize, so that you know what is, you know, under each and every head, what is the status. Then from that you interpret and communicate, and financial information. So what type of information does an accounting gives? Accounting give information on the resources available. So what does this business is about? What are the various resources available with the business? So what is the, I mean, it includes even human resources, material resources. What is the resources available with the business? How the available resources have been employed? So how you are using the available resources, and what the result achieved by their use. So by using the available, for example, machinery, is the resources available? By using the machinery, what is the outcome I'm getting? I have so much of employees with this, with a different skill set level. By using these resources, what is the output I'm getting? So all that, a complete information is available in an accounting compared to the bookkeeping. So we can see one definition. And accounting is the process of identifying, measuring and communicating economic information to permit informed judgments and decisions by the users of information. And this definition is given by American Accounting Association. So here accounting is the process, right? It is a process. It is not an activity or something. It is a process of identifying, measuring, and communicating economic information, right? You're identifying information related to the economy, and you're measuring it, and you're communicating to whom? Anyone who uses the accounting information, maybe an employee, employer, and the customer, the creditor, the banker, the government, any users of the information. So when they see the accounting information, they get an idea about the status of the company, and based on that, they take judgments, they make decisions. So all the users of information can take any judgment related to the business by seeing the information, economic information recorded in the books of account, right? Thank you. And this is all about the introduction slide. And next video, I am planning to bring it on basic terms in accounting, right? Because I know there are certain terms used in accounting which literally have a different meaning and different application. But when it comes to accounting, it is having a new meaning and new application. So first, before learn anything about the accounting process, we need to get update with the basic terms in accounting. So that's what I'm planning to bring as a next video. And I hope this video is useful to you. You like it. So I am expecting your positive feedback from you. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.